Yeah. Good job with the band right there. Thank y'all. Well, I tell you what, I tell folks I'll speak at the drop of a hat, and I'll drop it myself. So let me drop it right now and say a few words to you and with you. I want to welcome you to the 17th annual Mississippi Economic Council Hobnob. It is not my first time, as Scott mentioned, and they do a great job here. But I want to recognize one very special person, my wife, Leslie, over here to my left. Stand up, Leslie, and wave at them. I tried to get her up on the stage, but she wouldn't come. We're going to get you up here next time. You know, I want to tell you how grateful I am for the wonderful career that I have had here in the great state of Mississippi. I don't know about you, but I'm proud to be from Mississippi, proud to be here all my life, raise my family here, get educated here, raise a family, have a career, serve in the legislature, and now have the great honor, the high and distinct honor of representing Mississippi's largest industry, our agriculture and commerce industry. I want to say thank you to Governor Phil Bryant again. I'm so grateful for him thinking of me. I really do believe that God has given me the skills to lead on this very crucial industry. From the fact that I began raising cows when I was 13 years old, all the way to the day, and the legal background that I have that has been very useful in recent days. I want to tell you that my legislative experience, we expect to be over the legislature with a limited agenda, but I'm so grateful for all the members there. It truly is public service to serve in the Mississippi legislature, and I appreciate all that they do. But I want to tell you, I want to serve as the greatest advocate for Mississippi's greatest industry, agriculture. I've been a little busy the last 7 months. From a statewide farm listening tour. A wise man told me long ago, good leadership requires good listening. Yeah, we got to listen, and then we've got to learn, and then we can lead. And I've been, as of today, in 76 counties across the great state of Mississippi, and I love every one of them. And before the end of this year, Lord willing, I'll make all 82, met with farmers, ranchers, landowners, listening to the real issues that we are facing, and working on them. Economic development initiatives have kept me busy. I'll talk about some of those. Fighting against unnecessary regulations that burden and hinder economic opportunities and hinder farmers from doing what we know to do. And developing our next generation workforce. The greatest investment you and I can make in Mississippi is in our next generation of agriculture and commerce leaders and all of our young people. Y'all agree with that? If you do, you can clap at that, all right? And if not, I'm going to pray for you. Because the greatest investment we can make is in our young people. I want them to succeed. I want them to stay here, and I want them to raise their family here and have the wonderful life I've been privileged to have and you have as Mississippians. Now, a few things I'm going to say. As I've been listening, I've been busy. And I don't believe in letting grass grow under your feet. I've been moving around the state and been working diligently on these issues. Let me share just a few of them. From the listening tour, from the Gulf Coast to the hills to the Delta, the Piney Woods. Our state is a blessed state. We have abundant natural resources, and we don't ever need to let anybody look down their nose at Mississippi, because you know what? We're putting food on tables around the world every night at supper time. We're putting clothes on the back of young people all around this world to wear to school and for folks to wear to work. And we are putting roofs over the heads of folks all over America and the world through our wonderful timber industry. I've been listening, and I'm ready to lead. 36,200 farms in Mississippi today. 29% of our agriculture, of our workforce is agriculture-related work. And two-thirds of those farmers work another job to keep the farm going. Listen, we need all our farmers, large and small, and we're working every day to make sure to get government out of the way so we can all succeed. We're blessed. And we are proud to promote Mississippi, poultry and timber, corn, cotton, sweet potatoes, soybeans, watermelons, Smith County watermelons. I tell you what, we got a lot to be proud of and thankful for. Economic development. I've been working on some very key projects the last 7 months, and I was recently elected to serve as Vice President of the Southern United States Trade Association. Trade and tariffs are a big issue. We have some tremendous opportunities. We shipped the first Mississippi chicken to India 6 months ago in over two decades. I'm proud of that fact. Yeah, you can clap at that. I told them in India, if they ever eat our chicken, they won't want anybody else's chicken. I love fried chicken. Let me tell you something. I've been working on some timber projects. You're about to see in very rapid succession some timber development projects announced around this state that's going to benefit our landowners and our timber industry. You know, just wait. We just had a groundbreaking yesterday in Copiah County, and there's more to come. Timber mill expansions, trade opportunities. We have two delegations coming to meet with the Mississippi Department of Agriculture and Commerce in November from other countries to talk about buying more Mississippi commodities. I'm excited about that. Working with Glenn McCulloch and the Mississippi Development Authority, we have some great opportunities, and we're just scratching the surface on those. I want to tell you, we've been fighting against unnecessary regulations. The Trump Administration Environmental Protection Agency is a breath of fresh air, no pun intended, all right? We had the first ever Mississippi Agriculture Roundtable with the United States EPA Regional Administrator. He came here to our office. He met with Farm Bureau and all of our agriculture industry groups, Delta Council, all of our main commodities, and we had a wonderful, positive discussion about how we can push back and fight back against unnecessary regulations like the waters of the United States. Do you know there was a regulation that would have taken over every drain ditch in America on my land that I worked and bought and paid for, and on your land and tell you what you could or couldn't do with it? That's un-American, in my opinion, and I'm so glad it got repealed and it's being replaced. And in fact, we had to fight a legal battle and get exempted from it here in the state of Mississippi. We've been fighting things like fake meat. There is a new threat to our cattlemen's cattle industry, beef industry, and it is called lab-grown meat. It can grow meat on the hair follicle of a cow. How about that? I don't plan to eat a dab of it, do you? I don't know about you. I plan to eat some real steaks, and I like mine medium well. And I want the world to know. We're about to file comments in a federal docket, filing comments on consumers' right to know that they're getting real meat versus fake meat. We're about to file those in support of our consumers and our local livestock producers. And then I want to tell you, finally, maybe the most important thing we're doing is working on workforce development for agriculture and ag-related industry. I've been meeting with folks at Mississippi State University and Dr. Andrea Mayfield of community colleges, and we're working on a comprehensive strategic plan for ag-related workforce development in the great state of Mississippi. One thing we're doing as the Department of Agriculture and Commerce, you can go to our website under employment opportunities, go to mdac.ms.gov and look under agency information, employment opportunities, and you'll find the Mississippi Agriculture Workforce Development Internship Program. And I want everybody here to know, maybe you know an 18-year-old or someone who's about to be 18 and they don't know what their career path is going to look like, but maybe they're interested in an agriculture-related occupation, in a career, working on the farm or an ag-related business. They can go to that website, fill out that form, send it in, and we've already had 42 students around the state of Mississippi sign up. They're going to be coming from on a statewide basis, interning through our department. I can't pay them a dime right now, but I can get them in the network of everything ag-related in Mississippi and put them in touch with their interests. I want to close with this. You've got some literature on your tables. Genuine Mississippi. It is our new branding and promotional campaign. We're proud to be Mississippians through and through, and we're promoting everything grown, raised, crafted, and made right here in Mississippi. And, hey, that applies to you. Whatever you're making, manufacturers out there, there's not one reason why you and your team can't be a member. You Chambers of Commerce, take this back home, get your local businesses plugged in, and we're going to promote everybody to invest in ourselves, invest in Mississippi. And in closing, I'm going around the state sowing seeds of opportunity. We're going to get what we sow. We're going to get more than we sow. We're going to get it after we sow. And when we get done, we'll all join together all across Mississippi and sing that great old song, Bringing in the Sheaves. God bless you. Have a great time here today at Hobnob. We'll see you all around. Thank you, Scott.